Science education is not just about learning facts in a classroom. It's about doing activities where students put their understanding of science principles into action. That's why the National Assessment of Educational Progress has developed what we call hands-on tasks. They're 40-minute activities in which students engage in scientific investigation by completing real science experiments. These tasks bring science to life. They help us to understand not only what students know, but how well they are able to reason through complex problems and apply science to real-life situations. Hands-on tasks are administered at grades 4, 8, and 12. Today, we're going to focus on one of the 12th grade tasks called maintaining water systems. For this activity, students are given laboratory equipment and background information they will need to perform their investigation. The students are presented with a challenge: where to build a new town based on which site has better water quality. What students don't know is that there is no right or wrong town site. Instead, they are evaluated on their ability to reach a logical, reasonable argument using the data they collect. The students go about the activity in stages. They use a kit that contains a map, reference charts, water samples, test strips, a stopwatch, safety gloves, and safety goggles, everything they need to perform their investigation. Using the reference materials in the kit, students are asked to form a preliminary recommendation about which site they think would be preferable for a new town. They must think about each site and the possible sources of pollution that surround it, like shopping malls, farms, or a coal mine. Once they complete their preliminary recommendation, the students then begin to test the water samples from both sites for levels of specific pollutants. Using the test strips and stopwatch provided in the kit, students perform a series of tests to determine the pH, copper, iron, and nitrate levels of each water sample. After they have repeated this procedure for both water samples, they compare the results to the colored reference charts and record their findings. Students need to determine whether the pollutants in the water samples from each site are higher than the national drinking water standards. The students are also asked to think about the possible sources of these pollutants and record their conclusions. They must then evaluate ways a water treatment plant could reduce or remove the pollutants. Finally, using all of the information that they have gathered, students determine which site would be preferable for building the town and are then tasked to develop a scientific argument for their answer. In addition to identifying the more suitable site, students must also explain which water treatment steps they think should be used to supply safe drinking water. After the assessment is over, trained scorers evaluate the responses to see how accurately students conducted the test and recorded their data, and how well they were able to draw and support their conclusions based on the findings they gathered during the test. For this particular task, 75% of the students who completed it were able to perform a high-level experiment, including correctly recording and interpreting water pollutant levels. The hands-on tasks are engaging and challenging. They allow us to test students' abilities to combine their scientific knowledge and investigative skills in a real-world situation. Hands-on tasks are just one of the many innovative ways in which NAEP measures what our nation's students know and can do in science. Teachers, parents, and policymakers all use NAEP results to help improve the quality of education.